Guruguru sub-county registers at least 8 cases of land-related conflict every month. People prefer to settle even minor disputes in the judicial courts of law.
People here despise our authority. They run to court only to be told that the LC1 should have settled this case. They also realize that the process is lengthy and expensive.
Oriem Santo is the LC1 of Amora village in Guruguru sub-county in Amuru district. He explains that most people believe that the judicial court is the only option in settling land disputes, but the expensive and lengthy process sometimes only makes matters worse.
But amidst that also, we have some people who cannot understand. And that's why as we talk now, we still have so many cases of land wrangle up to the court.
This elderly woman is a court caller. She is a widow after her husband Samuel was shot dead in 1988 by the LRA rebels, and she was left to raise her 6 children alone. However, when the war intensified, they were forced into the IDP camps for 10 years, and when they returned home in 2006, another clan known as Boro had taken over their land, and they were chased away like strangers.
My mother ran away, but I lived, I have three sisters.
Charles Oringa is one of the eldest children to a court caller. On this particular afternoon under the mango tree, overlooking the Guruguru Hills, the elderly woman is explaining her dilemma to a team from the Uganda police and Redeem International, an NGO operating in Amuru district to support widows caught up in land wrangles.
We are not happy. And at that point, the whole family members behaved like mentally unstable people. And there was no way of paying school fees.
Due to the land conflict, Oringa and his 5 siblings dropped out of school as their mother struggled to retain their land. In 2020, Redeem International picked up the case of a court caller to serve as a deterrent to perpetrators of land conflict in Amuru district.
Normally, when we do a case like this, it sends a message to the community that when you touch a widow's property, someone is going to come for you.
Patience Abey is the community liaison officer at Redeem International. She observes that the government of Uganda should carry out education surrounding land ownership in the rural parts of the country.
Use what we call the theory of change. Our theory of change is that law enforcement leads to deterrence. Deterrence leads to safety, and safety leads to prosperity.
And it is from cases like the one involving a court caller that the Guruguru county leaders call for empowerment so that people can respect the authority of the LOC1, LOC2, and 3 in the mediation process of land conflicts.
If possible, police and the judicial court should give us the LC1's backing so that the community members realize that if they fail to listen to us, they can be arrested.
Amuru district has a high rate of land-related conflict, and partly this has been attributed to the customary land ownership, poor land demarcation, and the presence of investors in the district. Joseph Omagor reporting for the news in Amuru district.